Blackstone presents Dark Hollow by Anna Katharine Green. This book is read by Jennifer Fournier.
Book 1. The Woman in Purple. 1. Where is Bella? A high and narrow gate of carefully joined boards, standing ajar in a fence of the same construction. What is there in this to rouse a whole neighborhood and collect before it a group of eager, anxious, hesitating people? I will tell you. This fence is no ordinary fence, and this gate no ordinary gate. Nor is the fact of the latter standing a trifle open one to be lightly regarded or taken an inconsiderate advantage of. For this is Judge Ostrander's place, and anyone who knows Shelby or the gossip of its suburbs knows that this house of his has not opened its doors to any outsider, man or woman, for over a dozen years. Nor have his gates, in saying which I include the great one in front, been seen in all that time to gape at any one's instance or to stand unclosed to public intrusion. No, not for a moment. The seclusion sought was absolute. The men and women who passed and repassed this corner many times a day were as ignorant as the townspeople in general of what lay behind the gray, monotonous exterior of the weather-beaten boards they so frequently brushed against. The house was there, of course. They all knew the house, or did once. But there were rumors. No one ever knew how they originated, of another fence, a second barrier, standing a few feet inside the first and similar to it in all respects, even to the gates which corresponded exactly with these outer invisible ones and probably were just as fully provided with bolts and bars. To be sure, these were reports rather than acknowledged facts. But the possibility of their truth roused endless wonder and gave to the eccentricities of this well-known man a mysterious significance which lost little or nothing in the slow passage of years. And now, in the freshness of this summer morning, without warning or any seeming reason for the change, the strict habit of years has been broken into, and this gate of gates is not only standing unlocked before their eyes, but a woman, a stranger to the town, as her very act shows, has been seen to enter there. To enter, but not come out, which means that she must still be inside, and possibly in the very presence of the judge. Where is Bella? Why does he allow his errands? But it was Bella, or so we have been told, who left the gate ajar. He. The awe and terror of the town, the enormous, redoubtable, closed-mouthed Negro, trusted as man is seldom trusted, and faithful to his trust, yes, up to this very hour, as all must acknowledge, in spite of every temptation, and they had been many and alluring, to disclose the secret of this home of which he was not the least interesting factor. What has made him thus suddenly careless? He who has never been careless before. Money? A bribe from the woman who had entered there? Impossible to believe. His virtue has always been so impeccable. His devotion to his strange and dominating master, so sturdy and so seemingly unaffected by time and chance. Yet what else was there to believe? There stood the gate with the pebble holding it away from the post, and here stood half the neighborhood, staring at that pebble and at the all but invisible crack it made where an opening had never been seen before, in a fascination which had for its motive not so much the knowledge that these forbidden precincts had been invaded by a stranger, as that they were open to any intruding foot.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.